on the previous episode.
Why are you clapping for his booty? Is it an impressive booty? I can't even... Oh, that is an impressive booty.
And now, continued.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. Our park is looking relatively lovely. As you can see, the Hybodus has disappeared, and I'm going to explain why. Basically, they kept getting beached over and over and over again. Then one died from illness, and I thought, I can't leave the other one in there to die of social anxiety, essentially. So I figured it was time, and we'll just get rid, and we'll focus on having this exhibit as a... Archulot exhibit, like so. Boop. And boop. Cool beans. What a start, eh? What a start. Now, theoretically, and this is only theoretically, if I make this shallow water here, this guy, these guys, I should say, or this guy and this girl, this chap and this chapette should technically be able to go into land, I think. I don't see why they wouldn't. You know, it should work. So I'm hopeful that it will, and we shall find out momentarily, I guess. Or they'll do exactly what the sharks did and just get stuck on absolutely everything. Pam is pregnant again, because Pam is always blooming pregnant. Pam doesn't know what it's like to not be pregnant. This silly woman. Yeah, but this is, it's lovely. Very, very cool, I think. I think this is the right water type. Let's just... Yeah, looks good to me. Pam just gave birth. Hooray. Hi, guys. See, he's on land-ish. It's a turtle. It can go on land. Why do aquatic creatures hate me so much? Why do aquatic creatures love me... Love bugging out for me? Let's... Look. You like the land... There you go. Look, and now he's a land creature. And then he turns around, and he jumps back into the sea. I'm going to go ahead and make this a little bit more sort of water. There's probably not enough water. They seem to like the water more. So let's go ahead and just make this all deep water, I think. Not all of it, but a lot of it. Just up to the fence. And make it shallow along here. That's better. They'll prefer that. You guys prefer that? Let's go swim with our turtles. Hello! They are very cool, aren't they? Hello! You're very buggy as well, but you're very cool. I shall groom you, and I shall swim with you. Where's your head? Where's your head? Oh, hello! Cool. So we got those guys instead because it made sense, basically. Now, let's check our mapperoo. What are we doing? I think it's dinosaur time. It's dinosaur time, ladies and gentlemen. It's dinosaur time, which means we're gonna go for... Boom. Boom. Pachyrhinosaurus. Basically. Pachyrhinosaurus is not contained. Of course he's not. Cranky. I mean, he definitely is contained. He's very clearly contained. Gone a bit mental, isn't he? Let's go ahead and drag our dinosaur fence along to there, I guess. Since the game's going to be picky about not letting my dinosaurs eat my guests. picky game. Nice little river there. Very cool. Pachyrhinosaurus 1 is definitely contained. Or is that fence not working because it's all yellowy and stuff? Let's try to fix that, I guess. With smooth. Okay, that didn't work. None of that's working. This fence is ruining everything. How do I fix this? How am I going to fix this? Let's get rid of that bit of fence. Let's get rid of all the fence here. Make some money over here. Eh, meh, thank you. Okay. First, smooth. Let's... That should work, I think. Maybe? Meh. Aquatic creatures in this game all have an issue. There we go, that's better. Oh, no, it's not. No, it's definitely not better. Come on, Pachyrhinosaurus. There we go. Who's nice and happy and contained? Oh, crikey, no, you're not. Maybe that wasn't the problem over there. Right. Are you contained? You look contained to me. We'll get a proper look at you in a second. I'm trying to make you happy here. So let's get you some things. What do you want? Got some leaves. We'll get you a bowl. It's easy to replenish. There you go. Lovely jubbly. Some nice little plantaroos. Nice and plentiful exhibit. Okay. Some rocks. Everyone loves rocks. Already gave him some rocks, but we have more rocks. Some nice paleo looking trees there. It's a nice looking little exhibit, this. Oh. You're the cheapest. Scratching post it is. And, a rock shelter. Oh, we're going to get that. And I think that's all he needs. As long as we put in a fence-a-rooney. I don't know why it's called a fence-a-rooney, but it goddamn is, okay? Oh, crikey. Don't know what I did. Don't know how I did that. Okay, so now we need a path over there. So that's back to there, up to there, around to there. Brachyrhinosaurus, welcome to Jurassic Park. You are very, very, very cool. Very, very cool indeed. I mean, you stick out like a sore thumb amongst the textures of the actual game. You can see part of the textures. I mean, the floor's been retextured and stuff. Awesome. Hello. Your back feet are bizarre. Kind of look like a dog's. Interesting. Hello. Arrgh. Can I ride you? No. I should just clean up your poop instead, as it comes out of you, seemingly. Because I'm a classy guy. What can I say? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new dinosaur. If we head back to the entrance over here, you can see as well that I've gone ahead. I increased ticket price to expensive because money's becoming somewhat an issue. I was going to go into freefall mode, but before, about 2 seconds ago, I did actually have quite a lot of money. So it wasn't really an issue. But, like big buts and again, I'd like. We have added two new creatures just in this episode, which is a first. Admittedly, we already had the exhibit for these ones, but that's not the point. Okay, what should be next up? Now, Pam's having a billion babies, but we're kind of used to Pam having a billion babies. The baby over here, you'll notice we've got three of these guys now, because they've kind of grown up. We did have a baby one somewhere. That's Big Daddy. This is a little baby. Or was a baby. It's no longer a baby, clearly. Hello. I like these guys. I'm a big fan of their work. Yeah, it's nice. Now, if I've got this right in my head, we should be back onto these guys next. We should be looking at extinct animals that aren't dinosaurs. Aurochs don't particularly interest me. I think we're going to do a refresh and see what we get. Oh, the dinosaur there. Pinchosaurus, what's that? The Duuuuuude. I don't know what that is. Maybe that's something very exciting. Maybe it's something very boring. Who knows? It's half the fun. What's that? An aquatic Sicilian. It's like a sea snake. Protoceratops. Is that what I just built over here? Hot desert. No, that's different. Protoceratops is little and tiny and adorable. What else have we got? A mono island iguana. That is definitely just a sea snake. A protosevia. Could be our next aquatic creature. Ooh, Pachycephalosaurus. It's like tropical rainforest. Is this tropical rainforest? Mr. Pachyrhinosaurus, what is your favourite biome? Boreal forest, not tropical. So that's not going to work. Severian 3 wants to reproduce but can't find a mate. Well, she'll get over it then, won't she? Or he, that's the case maybe. I'm sorry, Severian 3. Dodo 12. Dodos have been so busy, all they do is mate constantly, making many baby dodos. What else we got? Hybodus again, which we could do, but why is it 12 grand this time? I thought it was 5. Whatever. He'd have to go in his own. Ooh! It's a giant. Ooh! Hello! Oh, you're definitely next, aren't you? You're awesome. Oh, and a new type of shark. We're gonna put. Okay, that's gonna be our next water exhibit. A double sort of watery, sharky thing, basically. Now, first things first, we should really get another Styracosaurus. Wait, Styracosaurus? 45! You're new as well. I need new Pachyrhinosaurus, is where I was going with that, because we can't just have one, because that'd be mean. But we're going to have to, because I just refreshed the thing without realising. So, basically, I'm sorry, Mr. Pachyrhinosaurus, you're kind of going to have to chill on your own for a little bit. I don't really have an alternative anymore. I'm sorry. Aww. Wait, what the hell? Why is there a ball over here? Who wants a ball? Do you guys want a ball? Where's Rob? There you go, have a ball. Okay. And let's just clear some trees out because I need a bit of cash. Best way to make money, this. Makes my park look boring as all any hell, but by far the best way to make money. I mean, money's okay. Since I've raised the park to... It's weird because raising the park up to expensive doesn't actually seem to have an effect on how many guests you get. People are willing to pay to see dinosaurs, no matter the situation, really, which is... Oh, fairly accurate of what the situation would be for most of us, I guess. Anything else I can delete for money? Any other nature I can destroy for my own capital gains? Yep. What's more delicious nature? Okay, and we'll get rid of the bouquet. And lovely trees here. I can't make it too boring, but then again I can. So. Lovely jubbly. What we might do from next episode is I might spend a bit of time, make a park, and we'll go into freeform mode so I don't really have to worry about things like this. Because again, like with Minecraft, this isn't really about the game itself. This is about making something filled with dinosaurs. You know, that is the priority. But this is enough that we can go and we can start building our exhibit for this awesome little chap. So let's do that. So what type of fence do we want? Marine fence? Low marine fence? Really? Is that really appropriate in the slightest? Alright, we're going to go for low iron bar fence, and it's going to go... I don't know. I'm going to have to flatten this area by the looks of things, because that is not going to work for an exhibit. Look at him run. Silly goose. What am I going to do here? Let's flatten the exhibit. Let's flatten. Flatten. That's not really working, is it? Let's just get rid of all this. Why are you indefeatable? Undefeatable? Indestructible? Okay, what we're going to have to do, I think, is put a path. Let's get a path tool. Figure this out properly. The path's going to go... I mean, I could put it there without too many issues. So if the path follows this along to there... And along to there. I can probably put it here if I just... Yes, again, do a little bit more remodeling. I can't see a dickens now because it's misty as all hell. That's lovely. Let's get rid of all of this. Nice and flat. Lovely jubbly. Screw you, natural terrain. Ooh, crikey. Really don't know what button I'm hitting to do that, but whatever. And let's just... But it's in the... whatever. Okay. So, you see my money's going up a lot quicker than it was last time. It's awesome. So, I'm very excited. Very on edge. We need to... I'm not really, Zoo Tycoon 2's not going to last much longer. I think 4 more episodes, including this one, so it's going to finish off this weekend, basically. So, I kind of want to make this the best park possible before that time comes. I'm afraid. Just because, I don't know, the game could theoretically go on forever, it's just... I don't want it to. Is that big enough? It looks fairly tiny to me. But I'm sure it's not, really. It's about the same size as that. Well, it's a bit smaller, but... No, that'd be fine. He'll be fine. Okay, desert. This is our first deserty exhibit, really. This fence is rubbish. It doesn't contain the biome. In the... Okay, let's have a nice little... Can we make this really small? I'd like to do a bit more modelling in that kind of sense, you know? And all the grassy bits should be on the coast of the water. But the bush is too big. And that's the max minimum. That's the max minimum? Okay, where's just... So, see? I quite like that. All the grass is by the river, as it would be, because it's got the water source, and then it's all sort of dirt and sandy bits towards the edges. Just like a woman I know. Like most women I know. Let's get some trees. It's quite a nice little exhibit, this. Nice big tree. Just one big tree, I think. Maybe two big trees. Ooh, crikey, you can eat a lot, can't you? You greedy son of a gun. Put that there. You can have a scratching post because tar pits are expensive. The rock shelter, but we will research. We'll do that next. Let's get a few plants for this area, make it a little bit more interesting. Some cacti, I think. Prickly pear cacti. It sounds delicious, frankly. And some of whatever this stuff is as well. You can place the spinosa. Okay. And some rocks. Ooh, you're a big one. Betty gets that all the time. Okay, very cool, nice looking little exhibit, I think. And obviously I can't afford the little critter yet, I need 10k. But this is sort of where I'd end the end of the episode. And I'll go off and I'll sit here and wait for my money to build up, basically. So I don't want you guys to have to experience... Ooh, crikey. Ooh, first anniversary. 20th anniversary? 20th anniversary blimp, though. I want a blimp. I want a blimp. Give me a blimp. All these awards. What do I get for that? Have monitors. Oh, okay. Okay, you kind of broke the game for a second there. There we go. That's a nice exhibit, this. Quite looking forward to filling it up a little bit. Ooh, my Archelon's pregnant. Apparently, bugging out and spamming yourself into the walls will eventually get you pregnant. It's Father Christmas! Why is Father Christmas in Zoo Tycoon? Where's my present? Kill him. Can I shoot him down? Can I delete him? Can I sell Father Christmas? How do I sell Father Christmas? Quickly! Sell Father Christmas! Sell Father Christmas! Bye-bye, Father Christmas. Okay, so as per usual, what we're going to do is we're going to do a nice little tour that pretends we are... Ooh! Hello, Mr. Rhino. We are a guest in the zoo. Let's explore. Do-do-do-do-do. Very nice entrance. Oh, thank you. Lovely man with an afro hair that makes it... Oh my god, you have the best beard in the world. It's like a mustache that attaches into an afro. It's a mustafro or an afrash. Afrash sounds... Afrash isn't a nice word. Afrash sounds like a medical condition that you definitely need to get looked at. You're dapper, aren't you? Oh my god. No, you're dapper. You are... Wow, you're stylish. There's nobody there, sir. You're waving at an ATM machine, which is fine because you're beautiful. Oh, crikey. It's Mustafro, man. Mustafro. Mustafro or Ashrash? No, we're going Mustafro. Okay, so you come in, you buy all your things. You may spend a lot of time in the terrifying dark room there. Talk to this woman. She's just chilling, doing what she does. You see the terrifying dinosaur slapping himself on the booty. And you think, what do we like? We like mammals. Let's walk over here. I'll clean up the trash can because I'm a helpful citizen. Oh, look, dodos. They're adorable. I shall donate some money to said dodos. Boop! I quite like having so many dodos on one exhibit. That's actually pretty cool. And... apologies if you can hear the rain outside. It has started pouring it down. You chat to this little paleontologist woman who's clearly been working for a little bit too long, but... whatever. And you walk along and you say hi to these guys who are right up by the gate. Hello. Hello. I shall groom you. For I have no boundaries. And you follow the path along. Oh, what's this lovely exhibit? Coming soon, I bet. And it is, you turn around because you don't want to look at an empty exhibit, because you're not silly. You have a delicious banana. You love the zoo, as the message at the top tells you to do. And then you open the gate because you're a bit of a rebel. I think, okay, that was fun. Can we do better? Is there any marine exhibits? This is like a bit, isn't it? Oh, look, water. That probably means a marine exhibit. Look, things. I totally can't remember the name of. Terrifying things. They are adorable. Let's walk past them. Follow this very bobbly path that has assumedly killed several people in the past. Walk down here. You don't want to look to the left. You don't want to ruin the surprise. Take some photos with your crappy camera. With your little your camera phone, I'm sure. You pull out your iPad, take a photo of the animals because you're that person. And then you turn around and oh my god. This actually looks really cool from down here. Archelon 1 definitely does have land to lay eggs. I'm going to have to fix that. And you come up here, and hopefully eventually these guys will figure that out. I'm going to fix this, because I want these guys to be able to breed. What we're going to do... I think I can fix this. It's just a bit of terrain modification. If we smooth out... that... that should... kind of make it into a ramp more than it is right now. I'm going to lower this down a little bit. That's not lowering, that's hilling. Hilling is an official term, in case you were wondering. Okay, and we smooth all this out. Let's get a nice big brush. That should. I mean, that looks pretty good to me. Let's clean the water. You know, it's definitely. Can I walk out? Yeah, you can definitely walk out. It might be a little steep, but it should work. I'll clean the small poop. Fine. Yay, Archon's gonna build a nest. Let's go look at that. I wanna watch this, see if anything happens. So let's go into the exhibit. That's Archon 1 there. Hello, are you coming onto land? Come on, little one. Push. What are you doing? Come on, it's really not a very steep ramp. You can do it. Do I need to make this easier for you? I feel like I do. I feel like I shouldn't, but I feel like I do. Really? Okay. Let's just... Oh! No. Wrong button. Completely the wrong button. Well, it's not. It's actually what I wanted. Look, that is a nice smooth ramp for you there, sir. There's no way you shouldn't be able to... For God's sake. knock it down a little bit. That is the rampiest of all ramps, okay? There is no way you can't do that. That is ridiculously easy to get up. It's Santa Claus! No, I'm not even underwater at this point. Now I am. That is... Come on. Come on, Archon, you can do that. Let's have a look at Santa Claus. Santa Claus, come back! You never gave me anything for Christmas. I love you, Santa Claus. Okay, the Archon's going to continue to be stupid, so let's leave her to that, I guess. We have to finish off our little tour. Boop. Yeah, we end up on a hill for no apparent reason. Look at our giant turtles. They're adorable. Lovely. Ooh. I see a dinosaur gate over there. Maybe there's dinosaurs in this park. Maybe I should follow this big bridge I haven't followed before. Ha ha! You know, I should do. Get some candy floss, you steal it and run away because you're a rebel. And then we go over here. Walk into people, because that's what you do. You do what you want. Dun dun dun. That is pretty much Santa Claus. Ignore the head. Just look there. Oh, look, a swamp. Just what I like in my parks. We look at the kid who seems to be happy about something despite the fact that she can clearly only see the wall and not in. But when you see an awesome little dinosaur, so that's very, very cool. And then you turn around and you go over here. You don't fall in the pond, which really is a health hazard if you think about it. And you have a look at these lovely chaps that you can't... Hello. Oh, no, I'm just about spotting them. Hello. And then you drown. And thus ends your trip to Zoo Tycoon 2. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Please like and subscribe. And I see you lovely people in the next episode. I say that, but Archon 1 has finally managed to get onto land. I'm hoping this is somewhat realistic. And as soon as she's done seemingly humping the ground, there should be like multiple... Oh, crikey, hello. There should be multiple babbies, shouldn't there? If we're being realistic. And they should all sprint for the sea to try and avoid the horde of seagulls trying to eat them. But I think she's just going to lay the one egg. So hopefully, we'll see an adorable baby Archon pop out at some point here. And now she's going to spend the next half hour desperately trying to get back into the land and... Oh! Oh, you scuffle little dickens. Look at you go. Goodbye. Goodbye, my lover. I should clean the water for you because you've been beautiful today. I'm very impressed with you. That was really cool. This is the benefit of hybrid exhibits, I suppose. Look, I've achieved something, ladies and gentlemen. I've achieved something Zoo Tycoon 2. You'll be very proud of me. Anyways, the plan. We're going to save up some money, fill this exhibit because at the moment it's a bit dull. Put some more donation boxes down because donations are a huge part of your funding and I don't have any over here that I can tell. So we're going to need a couple over here. Make ourselves some cash. One over here, one over there, that kind of thing. And then we're going to get this awesome chap. And then it'll be time for maybe the Kentrosaurus? Maybe this... No, we've already got something Styracosaurus. maybe the Pachycephalosaurus. We could do Pachycephalosaurus and Styracosaurus in one exhibit, though, which would be pretty cool. Actually, Hot Desert, is that what that guy wanted? We could, theoretically. No, Semi-Desert, it's completely different. Guests need more bathrooms, I'm going to do that now, because apparently I care about my guests' well-being. I don't remember signing up for this, but apparently I do. How do I even do this? Oh, right. Okay. Bathroom. Family restroom. If I just stick that there, I'm sure people will figure it out. Okay, until then, cheers, much love, bye-bye.